happy you are what you are in this world. That's either one of two things. Either you're somebody or you're nobody.
A lot of this is behind the scenes or under the hood.
It's time to just look under the hood. No stone should be unturned.
I don't even know what that means. Look under, I got an engine underneath my hood.
Most important thing in business is honesty, integrity, hard work, family. Never forgetting where we came from.
Hey, pop the hood.
Pop the hood?
Pop the hood.
Welcome to the Under the Hood podcast with Jonathan Hood. Across 110th Street, pushers won't let the junkie go free. Across 110th Street, woman trying to catch a trick on the street. You bet it.
Standing here with the legendary Sugar Ray Leonard. Ray, how does the show look to you so far?
Well, Larry, I'd score the show pretty. So far, the audience has been able to take everything that the cast has dished out. If we look at the tail of the videotape, we'll see that the audience outnumbers the cast 30 to 1.
Let me ask you something. If you were in this cast's shoes right now, what would Sugar be doing?
Well, Larry, like I said, this is a very, 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 very tough audience. And remember what they did to Frank's place. If I had the cast right now, I'd be going for the knockout. Like I did against Marvin Hagler. He scared me. He looked like a giant milk dud. This milk dud had arms and was jabbing.
Ray.
I was jabbing back.
Ray.
Only thing I could do.
Well, looks like we're about ready to start that fifth round.
To use a
ladies and gentlemen, the great
way,
Sugar Ray Leonard.
I
thank
can
you.
Use bigger words than I usually use.
Welcome to the Under the Hood podcast with me, Jonathan Hood. Thanks so much for checking in on our podcast. It's brought to you by ID Plus Marketing Solutions. ID Plus, advertising, specialties, embroidery, silk screening, and more. Go to the website idplus.biz. That's idplus.biz. Or call Fred at 219-677-5800, 219-677-5800. Ask for Fred, our newest sponsor for Under the Hood and our podcast, ID Plus Marketing Solutions. You need something done for your business, ID Plus can help. Our guest today is Tommy Davidson, actor, comedian. He joined us here on the program to talk about his show taking place on Saturday, December 22nd in the Chicagoland area at the Schaumburg Chicago Improv. For more information, go to chicagoimprov.com and get tickets there as well. He's got two shows, 7 and 9:15. Tommy Davidson was here this past Thursday, Friday, and he's going to be here Saturday for his last two shows. If you are in the area, stop by. A great comedian, Tommy Davidson, at the chicagoimprov.com. In our conversation, he talks about his career, who makes him laugh. He talks about working on the Foxx network. He also gives his thoughts about where the business is going as far as comedy is concerned and his career. You know, this is Tommy Davidson, the guy that was on In Living Color, who also was in the movie Booty Call. He has been a voice actor for quite a long time as well. So he's had really an incredible career. And I think he's more at ease now of things that he can see, things he can control. I think he's very happy with his life. Let's hear now from Tommy Davidson, comedian, actor, with us on the Under the Hood podcast. Tommy, as always, I appreciate it. Thanks so much for coming on. As Tommy Davidson will be at the Chicago Improv. Go to chicagoimprov.com for tickets. A show tonight at the Chicago Improv in Schaumburg. And then two shows on Saturday, 7 and 9:15. Go to chicagoimprov.com for tickets. And if you're like me, and I told Dion Cole this, make sure you get in line early. Don't have to be standing out line. All the way to the mall, I had to stand out. Because you know it's going to be a little chilly. I'm going to be in my gaiters. So make sure you get there early
to see Tommy Davidson. Yeah, because it's going to be cold.
Yeah. Thanks for joining us, man. How you doing?
Pretty good. Pretty good. I'm liking Chicago football right now.
Yes. Yes. It's been a minute.
I called it early because I saw that quarterback. I saw that quarterback the first time I saw that quarterback. I was like, they finally, all these years, got a quarterback.
Yes. Finally,
like
somebody.
Him.
It's about time, Tommy. It's been a while since you've seen the Bears in the playoffs.
I mean, I don't know where the owner got all that money to throw away all that money on the other quarterback. I don't know. You know, there's no way I'd have redone Cutler's deal for an $100 million.
Right.
There's no way. He didn't even show that.
Right. I was surprised. But you know what?
He never now, showed that he can play up to that standard. Come on.
I know. And now, Tommy, look at what's happening. Now now the team is good on offense and defense. It's working out really well for them.
It really is. I like the character of the team, too. You know, they're not overachievers. They kind of just get it done, you know?
Yeah.
They kind of just get it done, man. They're playing together. So we'll see.
Tommy, you tell me, man, how's life been for you right now? How's life for you in 2018?
Really good. Really good. I'm at that point where I can do what I want to do, go where I want to go. You know, I'm actually starting to feel the way I want to feel, too.
Mm-hmm.
more than not, you know?
Right.
Travel the world. Got great home, L.A., Houston. You know, I got plenty of good people around me and know how to enjoy the simple things in life. So, you know, the day's the last day I have until tomorrow, so don't let me speak too soon, but I'll take it, you know?
Right. So, Tommy, tell me, who right now makes you laugh? When you're watching television or you go to a set, who makes you laugh in 2018?
That's hard to tell. You know, right now it's hard to tell that because there's YouTube and all this other stuff going on, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And I don't really watch comics because I live in my own bubble. And even the comics that are, like, supposed to be the hot ones, you're not kind of funny up to my standard of funny, you know? My funny is a different funny.
Yeah, there's a lot of storytelling, and it's usually a lot of rapid fire. Where was your some of the guys that you looked at for comedy to kind of inspire you?
Pryor, George Carlin, Eddie. You know, I watched the best roll out, boy. Robin Williams was badass. You know, just I came up in that atmosphere of watching them at the Comedy Store, and so that's what built up my comedy. Paul Mooney and even Roseanne Barr.
Right.
You know, I was watching them, watching some really skilled people, some people that don't have such big names like Don Morera and Charlie Fleischer.
Mm-hmm. What is today's comics missing? What are they missing today?
You know, I don't know because I don't see enough of them.
But oh, come on.
There, it's not a lot of stage time. Mm-hmm. Not a lot of, you know, I guess in the fight world, it would be ring experience, you know?
Right.
You know, the comics that come from my era really worked a lot, rather got paid for it or not. You were trying to be, your material was what was important, you know, so you had to build up and build up and build up and build up and build a material. You couldn't get in the club with 5 minutes of material unless you're going to just open up for the, you'd be opening act,
mm-hmm.
you know. By the time you start doing middle at a club, you got to have 25 minutes. And if you're a headliner, you got to have an hour.
So it's kind of like being able to have reps and just get better and you just continue to take gigs
exactly.
and just try to get better, right? And so maybe not enough young comics are doing that enough. What, like, because that was your career. That was your experience, right?
Mm-hmm. But it works different. You can have a comic that can have a million hits and be hot on the internet, and a venue will hire him. A venue will hire him, and they'll sell the ticket. But that doesn't mean the acting is necessarily going
to
be good.
Don't
Some of them
to
just get one shot at that, I guess.
Yeah.
Right, once the club finds out.
ChicagoImprov.com for tickets. Again, Tommy Davidson will
be
there Saturday, and again, 7 and 9:15, two shows for ChicagoImprov.com. Get your tickets, get them online, or stop at the box office and make sure you see Tommy Davidson. I want to find out what it was like for you to eventually meet Sugar Ray Leonard and Sammy Davis Jr. because Sugar Ray, let me tell you, because and people, for young people that don't know, not only was Sugar Ray a terrific boxer, but also was a prime commentator on HBO. He was like the number one color analyst. And so when you first did Sugar Ray Leonard, it had me rolling because no one did that. It was so unique. What was it like meeting both of those guys?
Actually, it was really cool. I never met Sammy. Never had a chance to meet Sammy, but I did meet his wife.
Mm-hmm.
Me and his wife went down a long road trying to get his movie done. And unfortunately, God bless her, she's died in the process, you know.
Mm.
But I got a chance to be embraced by her. And Ray Leonard boxed in the same hometown that I'm from. And I started boxing because of him. I finally met him. He was like looking up to one of my idols. But he looked at me one time when I was doing an impression of him. And there was a look in his eyes. And I just realized, like, he knocks people out for a living.
Right, exactly.
I wasn't even really paying that much attention. You know what I mean?
Right. Exactly.
He gave me a look, boy. Boy, you would not believe. Just for 1 second. You know? If Hagler can't beat him, you know I ain't going nowhere near him.
Exactly.
You know? Right. I could do about 4 setups total, too.
Oh, it was just so perfect. And so, but just for that fleeting moment, you thought, well, maybe,
right?
Yeah, you thought something was going to happen.
Yeah, the timing. Yeah, just for a second. No, just for a second, I think he wanted me to realize that. He gave me a kind of like a blank stare, kind of look through me. I was like, okay, I know what that means. You know what I mean? I may be funny, but, you know?
Right, exactly. You don't mess with me.
Right, you may be funny, but.
Right.
Thurman Thomas gave me that look, too, one time.
Oh, what happened there?
I was doing some comedy at Derek Thomas's celebrity golf tournament. You know, I was kind of making fun of him. And he gave me a look. I was like, oh, I'm going to shift over to another player. I just saw his football life, by the way.
Yes,
I got to say he's one of the greatest running backs.
Yeah, no question
about it. He's one of the greatest running backs in the NFL. Yeah. He didn't get a lot of attention, and he's right about that. But when you look at his body of work, you look at the numbers, and if you see that football life, you're going to know that he's one of the top running backs of all time.
Tommy, I'm very interested in your involvement with the Foxx network on several levels. Because, of course, when you were on Unlimited Color, many of us here on the South Side had to break out antennas just to see you on Unlimited Color because Foxx network was not on the usual channels, right? You recall this, right?
Mm-hmm.
All right. So mm-hmm. what was your early moments and memories of working with Foxx? Because coming in, it was Tracy Ullman, and the short on that mm-hmm. show was The mm-hmm. Simpsons. There was Married with Children. 21 Jump Street. Good programming, right? And so,
yeah, with Johnny Depp.
Right. What did you think of the Foxx network when you first started working there?
I didn't care. As long as I was on TV. Mm-hmm. You know, I noticed that it was in a news lot, though. It wasn't like the other TV networks' lots. It wasn't fancy. But, you know, they backed us up. And going around the country and doing all the affiliates, doing all the news, all the Foxx News around the country, I became a star because of the Foxx network.
There's no question about it. And I think that the other thing is with that, Tommy, is that many thought when the NFL started going to Foxx, they thought, okay, is Bart Simpson going to be doing pregame, postgame? There was a lot of fear of Foxx because it was so new and brash.
Mm-hmm.
The television was nothing mm-hmm. like CBS, NBC, ABC, and the traditional mm-hmm. networks.
Mm-hmm.
And so I think that was – and also they thought maybe Fly Girls would be the cheerleaders from Unlimited Color. There was a lot of fear there. What do you
right.
remember about the NFL aligning themselves with Foxx?
Hosting the Super Bowl halftime.
Yeah.
And I think – I know for sure that that's when Foxx started thinking about having NFL on the network because we beat the Super Bowl halftime in ratings
mm-hmm.
that Sunday when we aired our live show right when the Super Bowl came on and we beat the Super Bowl's ratings. So I would have to think that that's why Foxx got into the not the only reason why, but I think that was one of the things that pushed it in that direction.
And then you did some work with NFL on Foxx as well.
I did. I sure did. And we were actually preceding all the other sports shows that are casual. You know, usually sports shows have anchors with the suits and the ties, and the subject matter is all sports, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And we mixed some pop culture in with sports on the NFL show that I did. So that kind of gave it that. Now, if you look at the NFL network and the shows that they have, they're very similar to the shows that I had on Fox for football.
Yeah. Tommy, I want to find out your thoughts on radio because I've heard you multiple times on the Tom Joyner Morning Show. Do you think that somewhere down the line that you would be able to do a daily show syndicated? Because I think that would be great.
It would be good, but they better write me a big old check. Man,
okay.
I tried radio. Radio is not easy
right.
at all. You know, it's one of the best. It's one of the best forums, though, and I would love to do it, but it just would have to be worth my time because there's a lot of time that you spend there doing things for the station and doing things for your program that takes a lot of time past your work hours.
Mm-hmm.
It's a heck of a gig, boy.
And Tom's been in it forever.
But I do it.
Yeah, and Tom Joyner's been in it forever. It had been Sybil Wilkes.
Oh, yeah. I know, right? They made it work for him, you know?
Yeah. I haven't met Sybil Wood. I'd like to meet her one day. What is she like?
Yeah, she's cool. She's cool.
Yeah.
Sybil's been around. I mean, I've been around as long as those guys, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I remember when Tom Joyner used to take, his idea of syndication was taking a plane to the next city.
Right.
Yeah, you know?
Flying between here and Dallas. He did shows right. in Chicago and shows in Dallas like every day. That's crazy.
Right.
Yeah, it's just amazing.
That's somebody said, you know you ain't got to go there, right? All you got to do is broadcast a signal, right?
But he decided, he's like, yeah, you could do actually both in one spot. And he said, oh, I could?
Right.
Oh, okay, I'll do that, sure.
But they couldn't do it technology-wise back then.
No, he could not. Tommy, I want to know about the first time that you received the script for Booty Call. What was your initial reaction?
Oh, I knew I was going to do that movie. Their initial reaction was, we don't want you.
Really?
Like, yeah, I had to go away. When I came to do that movie, they told me to go away. We're not what we're looking for, you know. So Bill Bellamy stepped in, and I guess they couldn't make his deal work, and they called me back.
Hmm. I can't picture that movie without you being there because it's still an iconic movie. How many people ask you about that?
Everybody who knows any better about funny.
Like it's still like it's still funny. Iconic today. That your dance scene and just a lot of scenes that, and actually it helps brothers. It helps us. It's still a guide mm-hmm. to be able mm-hmm. to figure out what you want to do in relationships.
Exactly. Exactly. I just was actually watching that same scene myself about a week ago.
Can you believe that's you?
Yeah. Yeah, I can. I mean, as long as I got a mortgage, I hope I can keep doing it too.
Right. Are you in the checks still come in, right? From syndication?
Right. Yeah, okay. yeah, but they're like $1.35. You know. I get 365 of them, I got something.
Right, right. Exactly.
You know.
You could do so with that loose change though, right?
Right, exactly. There's always Costco, man.
Right. Tommy is going to be at the Chicago Improv. Again, you can go tonight for sure for two shows. Then Saturday, 7 and 9:15, go to chicagoimprov.com for tickets. Tommy Davidson joining me, Jonathan Hood, on ESPN 1000. The sensitivity of people today, have you noticed a difference in crowds and audiences, Tommy, say 10 years ago versus now?
They're just a little bit more kind of a little fearful of certain things you say.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think everybody's really clear on what's really going on. A lot of confusing messages Americans are getting. So, you know, they know what to laugh at. They don't want to make nobody mad. And, you know, everybody's such a mob mentality, you know. All this stuff going on, you know, the media and politics pitting blacks against whites, which hasn't happened for so long. And it's not the way we feel about each other, you know. It's been promoted by certain parties or whatever. And then the violence that's going on with just random violence with the kids and in churches and stuff like that. It just seems like American people as a whole are just being attacked by a lot of negative. So you can feel when you're going through those, when you're on stage, you can feel when you're negotiating through those hard curves. I never really had a hard time with that stuff because I always was aware of what was going on,
mm-hmm.
you know, and what's going on in life. You know, everybody wants the same thing. So I just kind of base my comedy on that and don't teeter-totter too far on politics and all that bull, you know?
It's just that there was a time, doesn't matter if it was a Republican or Democrat that's in the office, mm-hmm. if somebody could do the impersonation or if there is a funny story out of the White House, it's just part of the routine. Mm-hmm. And now you're seeing people walking out because of the era of President Trump. It's definitely a far cry than what we are used to even just a few years ago.
Yeah, I mean, if a certain political figure is having you walk out of a club, mm-hmm. then, you know, as an individual, you are listening to the wrong political figure, you yeah. know. If somebody's going to have you walk out of a place where the object of the game is to laugh and have fun, then what kind of influence is this politician having on your thinking? And where are they coming from? You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I get you. There's no question.
Yeah.
I want to get also your thoughts on voice acting because I find it fascinating that the personalities come to life. I was talking to Sean Wayans about this and how difficult that is to be able to, because I think he's part of an animation where he's doing the voices and also trying to create the figures. What's voice acting like for you, your first role in that?
Oh, I started way back with Ren and Stimpy and The Simpsons, doing voiceovers and stuff. So I've been doing it a long time. With the Proud Family, Black Dynamite cartoon. I mean, just cartoon after cartoon. Just watching an old cartoon that I did called Cool Like That Christmas. Mm-hmm. Me, Whoopi Goldberg, Boyz II Men, did a Christmas special, an animated one. So I've done like dozens of cartoons. It's just another one of the skill sets I got.
Just think it.
I had to work on it really hard.
After watching cartoons and then seeing yourself on there, that's got to be kind of cool.
it's better than acting because there's no camera on you. So
right.
I could do whatever I want as long as I can make the sound. You know.
Right. Well, tell me what projects could you reveal to us? Projects that you're working on for 2019 that's not out there. Tell us, what are you working on?
I just wrote a book that's going to be coming out soon in the spring. So it's a Tommy Davidson Living in Color. Mm-hmm. It's just kind of like a biography of me coming to be in this daggone world, you know? Abandoned as an infant, raised by a white family in Wyoming, moving to Washington, D.C. at 5. That's stand-up comedy right there.
Right. Right. And that's going to be coming out this spring, you say?
Yeah.
Okay. I'd like for you to come back on and talk about it because I want people to be able to get that. Because I think that your life now, just talking to you, you seem more relaxed now and really more in tune to what you want to do in your life and your career than you did maybe 20 years ago, because that's just part of life and growing up, right?
Yeah. Yeah. And that's good. That's really good because things could have been a lot different, you know, and things are different for other people too. So it's just to have a basic idea of who I am. And where I want to go from here, having had accomplished so much, you know, I feel pretty good. I want the best for everybody, you know, and the best we can all do is to have enough to eat, to have a place to sleep, to have, you know, our fellow man respect us, you know, and a way to protect our children. That's everyone. If anybody is telling you anything different, then they're trying to take the rest from everybody else, trust me.
Well, don't forget, again, chicagoimprov.com is where you get your tickets to see Tommy Davidson. He's in town. Again, it won't be a Sunday show, but there's two shows on Saturday, 7 and 9:15, chicagoimprov.com, or go to the box office and get your tickets. Tommy, enjoyed the conversation, man. Thanks so much for coming
Thank
on.
You.
And continue to give us a smile. Now, the Bears make us smile, but the Bulls and the Hawks aren't making us smile, so we need you to come in town to help us. Put a smile on our faces, please.
I got you.
Appreciate it. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
You're listening to Under the Hood Podcast with Jonathan Hood.
You can take the children, bounce them on their knees. Bounce them on the knee and then sing a melody.
Great conversation with Tommy Davidson, actor and comedian with us. Don't forget, he's going to be at the Chicago Improv. Two shows on Saturday as we tape this December 22nd, 7 to 9:15. And go to chicagoimprov.com for more information. Great conversation with Tommy Davidson. And a lot of great conversations on the Under the Hood podcast as well in the year 2018. We're going to have a lot more for you in 2019. We've had a lot of fun this year, meeting a lot of new friends and talking to old friends on the podcast. But 2019 is going to be even better. We thank the good Dr. Sean Davis for producing our podcast all throughout the year. It's been a lot of fun. Good to talk to Tommy Davidson. We'll have more definitely for you in 2019. Happy holidays to you and your family. We'll talk to you again in 2019 with another edition of the Under the Hood Podcast, brought to you by ID Plus Marketing Solutions. I got one more thing I like to